tells scary stories of things that go bump in the night.
All right, so as promised, we're going to tell some ghost stories, and hopefully you can hear us tell the ghost stories over the freeway, which is right over our shoulder. So it's kind of cool. We got the atmosphere going, but we don't live in the middle of the desert or the middle of the forest, so we live in the middle of the suburbs, right next to the freeway.
I do not know who you are speaking to.
All right, so these are stories that we got from you guys.
So we are going to read some of your ghost stories. You've heard all of ours already. This one is from Justina C. My husband and I moved into a nice house, but for some reason I felt very, very uneasy in the master bedroom and in the basement. And I always got the feeling like someone was watching very close to my face. One night when my husband was working the night shift, I was home alone watching TV from where I was sitting. I could see inside my bedroom door and halfway in the hallway, and I kept seeing a black mass going past the door. Way inside the bedroom. And I just pushed it off, thinking my eyes were playing tricks on me. Well, after I was done watching TV, about 1:30 in the morning, I went to sleep. And when I was trying to fall asleep, I felt like someone was extremely close to my face. I went to sleep, brushed it off, and I ended up falling asleep. I woke up around 2-something in the morning, and I was laying on my belly, and I could not move. Nothing except for my belly. And this lasted for about 6 minutes, and it felt like a lifetime. After that night, I would not sleep in that room alone. I would not go in that room with no lights on. I left the lights on in the entire house, including the bedroom and the basement. That was the scariest thing that has happened. Things that make you
So my story comes from Saskatchewan, Canada, so I'm going to do it with a Canadian accent. Okay? Here we go.
Hey.
This comes to us from Jocelyn Faye Sage. This is my ghost story. It's something that happened to my mom and dad. They moved into a basement suite in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. I don't think I can say that. My older sister was just about a year old. Since it was the city, my dad had installed deadbolts on the door. So before they went out, they made sure the door was locked. My father had the keys on them. They went out for supper and did some errands. When they came back to the suite, the deadbolt and the handle locks were both still locked. When they walked in, they saw on the floor model cars that he had packed away in their own individual small white boxes. Some of the cars were out of the boxes, as if they had been played with. Aside from this happening, the only other occasion is when her mother would sleep with her. She would leave the house and walk out into the street. Now, the creepiest thing that has happened was years later, when she was in seventh grade. They were reading ghost stories in class. The book was called Ghost Stories of Saskatchewan by Joanne Christensen. For the month of October, the teacher decided to read for Halloween with the lights off and candles lit was Toddler Haunts Duplex. This is, which is another story about the haunting in the same duplex. Like another family that lived there.
So Josh and I had another story that fits the haunting of her parents.
So, and you can actually still buy this book. In fact, we bought it on Amazon for our Kindle. If you're interested in seeing the other stories from this apartment, and it's called Ghost Stories of Saskatchewan by Joanne Christensen. This next story comes to us from the Abyss, 92882. This happened on a Halloween night. This is when I lived in Paris, California, while everyone was getting ready for trick-or-treating. I was getting ready to pass out candy. While I was passing out candy to the kids, I happened to look inside the house and saw a little girl's face next to a fake plant. So when the members of my family came back for trick-or-treating, he had tried to get them to see the little girl. The only other person that could see it was his little sister. Finally, later on, when he went inside, he walked past this plant, and the little girl had gone.
She went out to get home. Our final story comes from Rooney Academy. When I was 13 years old, my parents went out for the evening, leaving me home to babysit my two sisters in our new home. They let me have my best friend over to spend the night, so I wasn't alone while they were gone. And after we put my sisters to bed, we were hanging out in the living room, watching TV and talking, when all of a sudden the TV went fuzzy, and I heard someone in a loud whisper say my name. I got goosebumps from head to toe and couldn't move a muscle. It was like I was frozen. I turned my eyes to look at my friend, and she was in the same state of shock I was. A few minutes later, my friend asked me what I heard. She said, I heard something too, but I couldn't understand what it said. It was my name. She said, you're kidding. Wow. All I heard was mumbling. We were freaked out, to say the least. So a few days passed by and nothing happened. Until one night, me and my little sister were hanging out in my room watching TV, getting ready for bed, and the same thing happens. The TV goes fuzzy, and I hear a whispering. I look at my sister, who is only 8 years old, and her eyes are bulging out of her. I've never seen that look on her face still to this day. I ask her what she heard, and she whispers my name twice. At this point, I tell her what happened to me just days before. We both slept together that night in my bed, freaked out. But thankfully, we never heard it again. Thankfully, we only lived there. And these are the things that go bump in the night around the neighbors' cauldron. Welcome back to the neighbors' cauldron. This is my mini cauldron for short story. And we have another story for you this evening from Rana 81206. We lived next door to an elderly man who was very ill. It got to where he could not do anything for himself. So my mother offered to help out many times. He always refused the help. He always said he didn't want anyone cleaning his house. A few months later, he passed away. The owner of the house asked if my mom would help clean up the house. She agreed. And we ended up moving into the house eventually. Everything was fine at first. But we started noticing things happening. We would come home and pictures would be across the room, on the floor, unbroken. The sweeper would turn off mysteriously while we were sleeping. It was always things that had to do with cleaning or changing the house. After a few months of living there, my mom and the little girl next door were sitting on the front porch, and I snapped a picture of them after I had them developed. This was before the digital era. We noticed something in the doorway. All my mom and I could make out was the outline of a figure, but assumed it was Mr. Grashel, the man who had passed away in the house. We had the photo blown up, and we took it to the daughter, who lived a block away. She looked at the picture and immediately said, "Well, there's Daddy." She could clearly make out his features and asked if we found the picture in the house. We told her we had taken it a few days ago, and she was all in shock. Nothing more really came of it, but we always seemed to linger around and delay our cleaning. When we did move stuff, nothing ever got, when he did move stuff, nothing ever did get broken. Although I had a trophy fall off his shelf once and almost hit my friend in the head. She swears Mr. Grashel was trying to kill her. She never stayed over again. Overall, he never really did anything to frighten us. But Mr. Grashel always stayed in his home.